which is compared to the first game and the pre-sequel, I'm probably going to run through this game a little bit faster. Which I don't know if I'm running through it faster than the but you know, I definitely will. Because I've played this game so many times, like I probably have over 1,000 hours in this game in my lifetime. So trying to go slow and listen to everything really makes me bored and makes me zone out. Which then I end up like skipping something or whatever, like a voice line or whatever, and I feel guilty. I'm like, God damn it, I'm trying to listen to everything. And my problem is that for me listening to everything, that doesn't make as much content. Like, I can maybe get a few, little bit more content, like, oh, ahaha, funny quest or something. But at the same time, if I'm going real fast, I'm going to get more videos. And I might run into that content faster. So it's like, yeah, there's the risk there will be less content. But it's going to be easier making it because I'm not going to worry about, you know, listening to every detail. And I'll get to the parts that I do like maybe a certain quest or maybe a joke or whatever. I'll get to that sooner. But I do want to make a statement from here on, at least with 2. This might change with 3, but for 2 at the very least, I am not going to sit around listening to everyone's dialogue.
And I'm going to basically
be doing this the fastest way I can. This shows exactly what I was talking about. So I literally thought I ran through this area already, when I guarantee I did not do this previously. I guarantee I did not do everything.
I want everything you got!
Okay.
Goddamn mercs!
Chance against them, you will need to up your arsenal. You could always arm your men with some high quality munitions from my store. If you buy from me, those
Okay. And the reason why the second option wouldn't get me anywhere is purely for the is mostly for the fact that I am doing this to revisit them, and well, for the pre-sequel, I kind of really appreciate it. Like I know that I like the claptastic voyage, not just because it was like just fan service, right? It was a really good DLC for the game, you know. And like Borderlands 1, it's not that hard if you're someone who's used to first person shooters. Now, if you're used to the previous game or the later games, it's a little bit more difficult. But you know, it's not too bad. But this game is one of those rare occasions where I'm just having a hard time playing it in the first place, and no matter what break I have, it's not getting easier. So that means I have to figure out a way to make it more, I don't know if I would make it more fun or something, but I just have to find a way that would make it better. And the only way I can think of is just trying to do it quickly. And at the end, when I'm thinking about it, and I'm like, okay, what would I say this game is, like, ranking-wise? I'll make that note. I'll be like, hey, guys, so, here's the thing. I've had so many, I already state the fact that this game is, you know, an oldie for me, so it's hard for me to appreciate it as much. But I will still note, be like, oh, you know, it's really good for DLC or whatever. But yeah, I'll go and drop it now, and we'll just keep moving on.
Nolan, I can't help but notice the bloodshots. You are fighting pack some serious firepower. If you are going to have a chance against them, you will need to up your arsenal. You could always arm your men with some high-quality munitions from my store. If you buy from me, those bloodshots will be dead in no time.
So he just reused the ad. So wait, hold on, is it? Wait, did I get to this area? I feel like I did, didn't I? Hold on, let me look at the main quest. What's my, oh, I'm doing side quests, that's right. Oh, I forgot. Okay, that makes so much more sense now, because I was like, why do I feel like I've done this before? It's because I literally did. I thought I had to run this whole area again. Well, I will for the other quest, but for this one, I have to actually turn back. Oh my god, I totally forgot what I was doing here. That's really funny to me. That's what happens when you take a month off. You're like, you come back, you're like, what the fuck was I doing? Okay. Alright, then.
You have about you. These mutants are not to be trifled with. Cut them no slack.
Me?
You killed my brother!
No.
Died on an empty stomach.
Okay.
Is that marshmallows and skaggerin I smell? Yummy! Come on in, dude!
All right, he's dead. dogs there. And you're supposed to go all the way around and set off a guy. But I knew with this special grenade, because of how big the area covers, you could hit from the outside with this grenade. It might be one of the only ones that you can do it with because of the fact the grenade doesn't actually have to get to it. It just has to be in the area of it. So it goes around the wall.
Ow.
also Splinter Quest is gonna give me a shotgun. I guess we can do both. We'll keep I want to keep the Firehawk shield because it can really help in a pinch.
You want this AI thingy in a gun? Fine, but just this once.
Oh my god. This AI thing in a gun?
Switching weapons.
It is unfortunate the mutants could not be tamed. They would have been useful allies.
Okay, let's do the math on this. So, it is more damage, but if we do, hold on, no. Let me get a calculator out for this, because, technically, what is two shots of this weapon? 56 times 6. Times 2, that damage, 672. 78 times 11 is 800. It is still more damage, even though it consumes 2 ammo. Okay, it won. I can't say it's weaker. Well, son of a bitch. I thought it was gonna be weaker because it uses 2 ammo, but nope. Apparently it is not, so he is being sold off immediately, I guess. No, we want to keep the, we'll keep the, increase the XP getting. We can't use that. We could use that, but I'm not. And grenades aren't good yet. So, let me think about this. The radius goes down by like 500. So, but it is 100 more shield. Continuously releases fire nova blast when depleted. But it recharges, the delay is so short that it's not really worth it. Or like, the chance of me not getting if the delay was longer, I'd say it's probably good. But the fact it's so quick does not help it at all. So I'm actually going to get rid of it for this. And plus, explosive is just better because it has just no resistances, unlike fire, which metal resists. So, let's sell... Can we not sell trash? No, we can only sell... And we can lock things so we can't sell certain things, which, in fact, I probably will do for that, but... You cannot sell all trash.
Don't have too much fun!
And I probably should head to a medical bay to heal up. Oh, that's right, I'm checking by difficulty trivial. We should go do that, but we should buy a slag weapon. Because the reason why I didn't do that quest was because I don't have a slag weapon.
If you got the money, I'll save your goddamn life. Try not to
die. Oh, that's healing, right.
Good choice. Well, be careful out there.
So, we need to go get a slag weapon. Let's go find that. Marcus... you probably have something for me. Okay. What time is it? It is... Okay, it's only been like... I don't think it's been that long.
A fantastic day for capitalism.
Where is your gun store? Oh wait, you're the gun. Oh, that's right.
How's that job going? I have quite a bit of
okay,
money
slag rocket launcher. Cool. can go kill the prospector. Now, I do have to be careful because of my ability. Because if my acid cloud kills him, that's not a slag weapon. But that is something to keep a note of, which is that we need to kill him with this rocket launcher. And even if the last 5% is done by the if it's done by the cloud or any other weapon, it immediately kills that. They don't go off of percentages; they go off of kills, like what got the last hit. Which means that if anything steals it from this rocket launcher, meaning we lose the bonus of this side quest. Which I will admit, sometimes I think the bonus is just more loot, but more often than not, I assume it's more EXP. And if it's the more EXP, that would be nice, but if it's just more loot, then that's kind of bad, because, you know, we're so much higher than this is. I need to move. Actually, hold on. I should really do this. Yep, gas cloud's used, so now I need to...
members of the opposite, or same, sex, whatever it is, bandits.
They made a deal with Hyperion? Hey, don't feel bad about wiping these idiots out. I guarantee you Hyperion would have done the same after the mine dried up. Go check with Tina. She's got a job for you.
Oh. I'm going to Tina with this info. That's actually kind of surprising. I feel like that always surprises me, because I'd always assume that, let's go back to the person who gave me the quest. And then this one was, like, the one different one where it was, like, it always surprised me. I'm like, wait, what? You want me to stay in that area and talk to someone else? Why?
Yo, 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 yo! Let's blow stuff up! Lilith told me there's a train full of money comes around here. Sounds like a job for a heist.
Those miners you fought earlier were paid cash in exchange for iridium. Get to the station where their payroll train comes in, and we'll have ourselves a good old-fashioned train robbery.
Hold on, I'm missing all my shots. Is that mine? It is, okay. I was gonna say, I thought I walked close to him, like, are they really not gonna explode that mine? Alright, is the train? Yeah, okay, it's right here. Dislodge gate.
Bandits used this station to rob passing trains. You're gonna have to use it to steal the bandits' payroll. Gotta love the irony. Use Tina's dynamite to blast the exit gate and block the tracks. Good. That'll leave the train nowhere to go.
Letter aid request received. Payroll train dispatched.
Is trapped.
Exposing cash vaults. Please load iridium shipment onto the train.
Better idea. Put the rest of Tina's explosives on.
to payroll train number 627.
Get back to Tina whenever you're done dealing with those Hyperion reinforcements, killer. Good job all around.
I just realized that I've always fought those cannons up there, but really there's no reason to fight those reinforcements. Like, literally at all. Since there's, I mean, I guess I could get more combat, more experience from combat, but at the same time, it's a level 14 mission. Like, I'm not expecting a lot out of these guys. And I'm just wrapping up missions, so. Okay, let's go ahead and talk to Tiny Tina.
When you made it rain, I was like, damn!
Grenade. So, make it rain. I should probably have looked up some of these, but I'll look up the rock salt and make it rain. So we can know what they do. I know I looked up the leather law. So, walk.
Salt. Here we go.
So, the special thing is, the unique ability is that nothing special. Yeah, apparently it is, there is no unique ability to this weapon. Huh, unexpected to say the least. And... make it rain. So this special ability is that the children grenade spawn in the air directly after the grenade is thrown. Right? Is that the grenade I'm looking at? No. Wait. Yes. Okay. That is what it says. Okay. Interesting. From my experience, it just has basically, the specialty of these grenades is the fact that they cover such a large area. And they're good when you're trying to hit it, or even in areas where it's a medium area, like bosses, like you're hitting a weak spot. You could throw it in the weak spot and it hits, like, that area 6 times, because their grenades don't get out of that area. Why is my mouse? As soon as I went to go do the video, it was like, nope. If you've enjoyed this video, do just have it at the top of the screen. If you have any questions, send them a comment below or to our Discord server. There'll be links in the description and our about section. Enemies are in the same 2 places as their associate. On the left is Regulation from YouTube, and the right is the series Borderlands 2 in its entirety. And I'll see you next time. Shades.